difficult to talk for 5 minutes about Lynn, but I'm happy that I'm here to just say a few moments of our happy times with Lynn we had for over 20 years. We met Lynn when Sir just finished making the database of irrigation from Nepal and India. And the FAO in 1993 asked her to do something similar to that in the forest ecosystem. The beginning Lynn thought that was going to be easy, but it turned out not to be so easy. So FAO identified a group of people, scholars from McKay University, and Lynn asked us to come to Indiana and start the development of the protocols for use in the IFRI program. So in the winter of 1993, she invited us for one semester long course, which was the first IFRI training course. But in that course, we were also expected to register for our postgraduate program, which was in the political science and policy analysis. And me, William, and some other colleagues, like the Kathleen Daka, who is here, so classmate, Leticia, that was the first group, and most of us were not political scientists, but didn't expect us to perform as well as political science professors who were also taking that class. Not exactly not a class, but it was a workshop of 17 weeks long. And I always say that it was almost like a baptism of fire, because he didn't expect us to perform as well as the professors. I think Ailey was in that class, and the Bob had just produced a book, which we had to decide in this presence, and that was Lynn's best of work. You call in the professors, the also of papers, and you depict us precisely. And we didn't have any knowledge in political science at all. I was a wood chemist, actually. My background, I have a PhD in wood chemistry. But Lynn was able, in the period of 17 months, weeks, to convert me from a wood scientist to a political analyst, which I think changed my life forever. So after the summer, the winter in Bloomington, Lynn came to Uganda to test the protocols which had developed over the 17 weeks. She came when it was a rainy season. She had never been in the tropical rainforest before. So we took out the forest for 2 weeks. We'd wake up at 5, by 6, 7 a.m. would be in the forest and start measuring trees. And she used to call hugging trees. That was her message of measuring trees at delta, breast at diameter height. She said, let's go and hug that tree. And sometimes the tree was across a river, and there was just one road, bridges to cross over to the plot. But Lynn would insist that she goes over and hugs that tree. She couldn't balance very well on the logs, but we helped her, me and William, on both sides, and until she crossed over. And sometimes there were massive boggy areas, but still Lynn would insist that she crosses over and measures all those trees. So to measure trees, identify the trees, so that we learn the problems of tropical forestry. And then every evening we would go to the communities and chat with the communities for almost hours. She enjoyed being in the villages with the local communities. At one time when I just want to start the if you work, the owner of the forest chased us away. But it took almost 30 minutes to an hour for Lynn to convince the owner of the forest that we met very good for him. So he allowed us, and from that time on, he became almost a lifelong friend of Lynn, and every year they would exchange messages. So Lynn never forgot her colleagues, so always worked with. Yeah, because that's another side of story which most people don't know about Lynn, that we always recognize Lynn from the books, from the papers, but she had a human touch. And one good example is that as soon as we fixed the site in Uganda, one of our colleagues went to Bolivia to set up a center in Bolivia, which was the second IFRI center in Bolivia. And as soon as that colleague of ours came back, he passed away, he died. But Lynn was so upset and said, I'm going to look after his son, he left his son. I'm going to look after that son until the boy completes university. And Lynn was able to keep that promise until when he died. And by the time Lynn died, the boy had entered the university. So there's that human touch which always doesn't show in the papers, always read, but he was really attached to the vulnerable people, always wanting help. And that's one of the reasons why our center, the staff cancer centers, cement so that we are funded for 15, 20 years continuously. And that's not easy to achieve. But Lean made sure that we have properly funded for 15 up to 20 years. And that way, we were able to contribute heavily to the IFRI database. I think all of us who have been at the workshop remember her at her forest home in the rural area. She made sure that whenever we visited Bloomington, she have a private dinner or private lunch with us. So that we not only talk about the commons, but talk about our social problems, our personal problems. And in that way, she was able to come to understand the African setup, the African culture, much more than we could get from the books. And we really appreciated that very much. I think all of us workshop tours know that whenever we're at Bloomington, there will be a cocktail. There will be food, there will be drinks. And Lynn made sure she served our guests personally. 20, 30, 50 people, she served them to their satisfaction. And during those cocktails, a lot of jokes, a lot of networking, and a lot of stories we have now remember kind of originated from some of those cocktails we always had at her place. As James said, Lynn was a workaholic. By force, he always woke up at 5 a.m. and she would send you an email at 6 and expect you to apply it by 7, otherwise you'd be in trouble. So that was the type of lady she was. She started working at 4 and ended up at 8 and switch off everything. After 8 p.m., you never get clean. Her computers, her telephones would be switched off, and she would make sure that she has a sleep up to at 4 and then start the whole day from 4 a.m. afternoon. So, yeah, Lynn changed a lot of us. Since I met Lynn, I don't think I ever did any more work in chemistry. Apart from teaching, but all my research has been geared to the commons. And that's how Lynn really touched me. And it's not only me who touched, but very many people who are in the audience here. Leticia, my friend Mwanji. And I think the IFRI people can put up their hands. Those were in the audience. Yeah. So this is the only first time since 1994 that we have not had an IFRI panel at these meetings. Which is, of course, very sad to us, but I hope we are going to work on it so that the next SSP we have a panel. And those were the most attended panels that whenever we met. So we are missing you. So thank you very much.